menu screen, option screen, character selection screen, instruction screen, game screen, pause screen, upgrade screen, game over screen, sunscreen. These are all the different screens you will encounter if you try out my pixel art pie game space shooter, Field Trip. I must point out that this is not a tutorial, although you requested me to show you how do I manage screens in my games. I'll guide you through the whole process later, but now let's just go over these screens with a spice of technical insights. So, how does this work in my game? For me, the easiest and most customizable way of handling screens is to create different methods for them that will be looped over continuously until a specific action tells the game to switch over to another screen loop. In other words, I have as many loop methods as many screens I want. So that is, I mentioned 8, but there's actually 10, some of them are early work in progress. One such method has all kinds of parts, like event handling, inputs, displaying, and updating specific game sprites. Each method has a unique key that I can refer to them with. For example, the menu is menu, and the game is game, and you can figure out the rest. Then I have another method that tells the game which method should be looped over based on the key I talk about. The screen manager method is the one that's directly looped over in the main loop itself. And you might question, how do I change this key? It depends. Sometimes it's an input of a specific key on the keyboard, sometimes it's based on the attributes of the player. It's up to you how you want your game to function. To follow a logical structure, let's start with the main menu. If you're a pro Orc Slayer Game Dev Channel member, you've probably seen a menu screen I made already. Which one? This one. I know, it looks good. I'm a sucker for UI. So, based on that, let's look at some versions along the way. In the menu screen, I wanted three choices first. Start game, options, quit game. Easy. Then I added a garage option, and probably there will be something like user or I don't know. Since it's a bit hard to read which option the spaceship refers to, I added a guiding line so it's clear where the cursor is. Onwards to the options by selecting it and pressing enter. And of course, it looks really it looks really nice. There I display all possible settings for the game. This game will be kinda heavy, so I prepared a bunch of performance settings early on. Here we can decide whether we want to display particles, turn on screen shake, etc. Let's just go for the more interesting parts now. Hit escape to go back and choose start game. We skip the garage now as it's in early work in progress. We're at the character selection screen now, where we can choose which ship we want to take for a ride. Wait, what? Multiple ships? Devlog 3 then. Okay, to make the ship mechanics clear, I prepared a bunch of ship-specific instructions. Now, let's grab a saucer and head into space. Now comes the instruction screen. No, it doesn't. What do you mean it doesn't? It's actually the pause screen.
I mean...
Stop playing. Share your secret.
Yeah, sure. I'm right. There's no instruction screen.
This is actually the pause screen, with a pretty simple trick. I have a switch that tells the game if it's a fresh round or not. If the pause screen is triggered first time in this round, it shows the instructions where I prepared another handful of information, although I intend to change this part. Pressing enter disables the switch and advances over to the real pause screen. Here we have a couple of arrows helping with the user interface. Instead of a single input, I implemented a holding mechanism, so if we hold escape, we surrender and get to the game over screen. But first, hit enter and see the game itself. Now, the only power in our hands to control the screens is the escape button to pause the game again. Other than that, we should play and see what happens. While we wait for miracles, let me introduce the pilot of the ship, Fractal. I wanted to name him Crypto, but I don't want to sound lame for mimicking Destroy All Humans. So yeah, he has all kinds of emotions that you will see along this series. And now, we reached the end of the level, so the game gifted us with three upgrade choices. The well-known holding mechanism is also present here, to avoid unintentional inputs. If you're struggling with the upgrades, Fractal will help you with his insights about them. Let's select one and head back to the game. Now, the only screen left is the game over screen. So give me a minute, let me dive real quick. Really? Come on. Okay, this looks fine. One little detail I missed is that the game accelerates more and more as you progress.
But when you lose, it gets slowed down to the initial speed. The score is also displayed, and I also added another hoarding bar. The project is still far from complete, and I plan like 40 more devlogs, so I need to step up my game. In the next part, we'll head inside the vortex and blast some space rocks with cool laser beams. Until then, stay safe and take care.